One of the things that I always look for in terms of engineering and technical talent is
most junior developers that I talk to believe that becoming exceptional is all about coding faster, learning more frameworks, or stacking up new languages. But let me save you years of frustration. After 2 years working at Uber, I've realized one crucial thing. Everyone around you knows how to code. Meeting the basic coding bar won't make you stand out. The real secret, there's a set of underrated technical skills that no one talks about. Skills that you will probably get to know after spending years in an actual job, and will feel almost like a secret if you know them early in your career. Hi, I'm Sanchit, SG2 at Uber, and in this video, we will discuss the 10 hidden technical skills that boost your early dev career. Some of these skills will be a requirement as you grow, while some are to take you to that next level where you almost feel like a magician and start to enjoy the real power of being a software developer. So let's get started. Number one is debugging. You know what's shocking? Even for senior engineers, 80 to 90% of development time is spent on debugging. When we are learning coding, it's mostly through a tutorial or guided environment, or maybe we are building some small projects. In these cases, debugging is not so difficult. But when you start to work in an actual company with collaborated environment where you don't know who wrote the code you are reading or working with, debugging is one of the very important skills that you really need. I know you are probably thinking that you will use ChatGPT or some fancy AI tool to help you with debugging. And I hate to break it to you, but AI won't help you in this. Recent research says even the best reasoning agents can create counterexamples for only less than 9% of incorrect solution, even though its ability is to solve up to 48% of these problems from scratch. See, irrespective of how much AI has progressed, it's still very much dumb and barely thinks logically. I asked it to generate an image of a person writing with left hand, and it repeatedly just gave me what mostly available in its dataset, a person writing with their right hand. And to stress upon how important debugging really is, let me tell you a real story. I was talking to a senior software engineer and got to know that in an interview, there was a candidate who was asked a multi-threading question. Now, multi-threading syntax and all that logic is not trivial, and the candidate struggled to make the code work in the first go. You might think that this was a negative point, but this one thing really stood out. The candidate was able to Google stuff, open different websites, go through the documentation, and actually debug the problem solution on the spot, and he was able to run the solution. And because of this one skill, because of this just debugging skill, that candidate got a strong hire. It's easy to write some code, but the real challenge is to debug that one corner case when you have so many moving pieces, especially when you're working in company's big code base and not your small personal project or a lead code problem. I'll stop here in the interest of time, but let me know in the comments if you want a detailed video on tips and tricks for debugging effectively. Number two is reading code. To debug code, you will obviously have to read a lot of code. Jeff Atwood, co-founder of Stack Overflow, explicitly says that software developers spend most of their time trying to understand code. To give you a rough idea, if I wrote 1,000 lines of code in the last month, I probably have read 10,000 lines of code. These numbers are made up, but I hope you get the idea. Apart from writing code, you need to build skill to be comfortable with reading alien code, skim through it, and understand it on a high level. And it will be especially useful when you are doing quality PR reviews. I guess I will have to say it again and again after every point, so better I just say it one time. If you want me to elaborate on any of the skill I mentioned or things like how to do good code reviews, do let me know in the comments and I will definitely make a video on that one. Third is readability of code. Since software developers read a ton of code, it's very important to make sure that the code is readable and also easy to understand. I have recently started taking interviews for non-fresher roles, and so does my college friends. So I was talking to one of my friends from other company about the interviews and what are the expectations, and I literally got shocked. A candidate was rejected because he wrote a function named parseMessage, and inside it, what he was doing it was, well, more than just parsing the message. And just because of this, because the readability of the code was not good, the candidate was rejected. Just the backend code base at Uber is like 90 million lines of code. And to keep it in a good shape, we have to ensure that the code we push is very high quality and easy to understand. Proper variable and function names, modularity, structure, avoiding difficult to understand things like hacky regex, and there's so much more that we have to be careful about. Fourth is full stack development. Now, this is something that my manager explicitly tells to everyone in my team. If you're early in your career, you should definitely learn full stack development. Even the senior staff engineers, which is like I'm SG2, so 1, 2, 3 levels above me, knows full stack development. They may not be best at both front end and full stack, but most of the time they can get the job done. I don't know if my data is biased, but the trend I see is many people just prefer to do backend because to them it feels more logical. No time to debate, but even if you think this, let me tell you, learning front end gives you magical powers. You can do things like live editing any web page and then flexing in front of your non-programmer friends, or create a script and run it in your browser to automatically accept hundreds of LinkedIn connection requests. Or what I used to do in college, just create a basic front end for any assignment, even if it didn't require that, and it really helped me stand out. For example, I was working with a friend on information retrieval and extraction course assignment, in which we were supposed to create pipelines that scrape the web and then optimize ways to search for the relevant information. My friend spent day and night building the best optimized pipeline, and I just created a basic frontend. But on the day of evaluation, the fact that we have the basic UI really stood out and impressed everyone, without much focus on how good the underlying actual pipeline is. Let me actually quickly go over to my laptop and show you. So this is the basic React frontend that I created, and I also deployed the UI on Vercel, which is a free deployment service. And as you can see, this is pretty basic, like please search and then the search box. Let me just quickly search for someone. Yeah, so this is the name of a computer scientist, then the photo, then the details, publications, we can expand, collapse, anything, and just the data that the underlying pipeline has scraped. This is nothing that the frontend is doing, it's just a normal table. We don't actually a very bad color thing, which is like green and yellow, but whatever. I know this is a shitty frontend, but the point is, seeing something on UI is 100 times better than just having an amazing backend. There was another time when I created a small basic Android app for an IoT project, but I won't bore you with details. I hope you get the point that learning full stack development can make you a software wizard that can help you in endless ways, especially if down the line you plan to do your own startup or something. The fifth skill is actually learning to learn. Fun fact, the half-life of most technical skills is just 2.5 years. You need to be comfortable at learning new, uncomfortable things. And how do you do that? Practice. Practice learning as much as possible to get better at it. Learning a foreign language makes you smarter, and same with software languages, frameworks, or any other technology. Keep learning new variety of stuff, and very soon you realize it's actually quite easy to get comfortable with any new language or framework. Let me tell you my own example. I was decent comfortable with both front-end and back-end, and when blockchain came, I was able to pick it up fast and was writing smart contracts in like a day. Is it because I'm smart? Not really. It's because I was comfortable learning new things. Sixth skill is to focus on fundamentals. Whenever you are learning something, make sure to focus on fundamentals. Because of tools like ChatGPT, it's very easy these days to just get an overview of anything and get started on it. But make sure to dig deep, read articles, go through a documentation, tutorial, and consume knowledge to understand fundamentals before jumping on anything fancy. Just pause this video for a bit and read this. Your goal isn't just building cool stuff. Your goal is to deeply understand how things really work. Write lots of code, play with it, do silly things, and all this will again help you with the first point I said, just debugging. I was not sure to include this skill in this or not, but the seventh skill is to talk non-technically. Irrespective of how much technical depth you have after focusing on fundamentals, make sure to communicate it in as simple way as possible, especially when talking to people who are not software developers. Don't try to show off your knowledge, and this is exactly what Uber CEO Dara also says.
One of the things that I always look for in terms of engineering and technical talent is, I'll ask them questions, and if there are some of them that try to use their technical talent like to lord over you, as power over you, they demonstrate to you how much smarter they are than you. And then there's a different kind of person who explains things simply. They want you to understand. They want to share their knowledge. That latter kind of technical talent is a kind of technical talent that I'm looking for, which is like, tell me why, tell me how this works. If they are able to simply explain a deep technical problem, then they've got clarity of thought and they're generous in terms of their information sharing, which is something that I'm looking for.
The eighth skill is command line scripting. Now, this is something highly underrated, but trust me, in certain scenarios, this can make you ultra productive. Remember that script to auto accept LinkedIn requests? Well, things like that and so much more you can do if you learn command line scripting, because then you can script literally anything you can do. You can automatically watermark photos. You can write script to automatically move your mouse every few seconds to keep your laptop awake and your manager thinking that you are still working. And I mean, there's just no limit of unimaginable things you will be able to do after you learn scripting. The ninth skill is technical documentation. Remember we discussed how software developers spend a significant amount of time reading and trying to understand code. One thing that helps us is good documentation. So while I agree it's not really the most exciting or interesting thing, at least to me, I must build a skill to document as much as possible so that it makes easier for future me and other people to understand the code I have written. You don't need to know how to write a novel, but you definitely need to know how to write a basic good readme. The 10th skill is Git. Mostly everyone learns programming through their personal projects, where they are the only contributor. So they are not really forced to use Git. But once you join a company, boom, Git is everywhere. And then most of the people I see don't put any effort to actually learn Git and focus on its fundamental, as I said before. and then forever have the fear of merge conflicts, clashes, branches, and so much more, making their software developer job a nightmare. So which of these skills resonated with you the most? Which skill do you think is the most underrated for junior devs? Drop your thoughts in the comments and definitely do let me know if you want a detailed video on any of the points I mentioned. And check out this video next because YouTube says you're gonna love it. See you in this video. Bye.